Zombie apocalypse.
Okay, so today's topic is soil bearing capacity of a multiple layer soil. So ngayon, we are going to discuss what if the soil is multi-layer, which is most likely the cases where both disturbed and undisturbed soil may most likely fall under more than one layer soil. Ano? So ito yung medyo titingnan natin, mas lalo na, especially when we observe the soil bearing pressures and the soil bearing capacity of such particular foundation. So let's start. Okay, so we have a problem like this, ano, using factor of safety of 3.5. So a load force value P again is to be found, no, acting on the column as a force, and it is a rectangular footing as per given is concerned. Okay, with the dimension of 1.8 by 3.75. So meaning the longer dimension is 3.75 with the specification of the layer of soil. So notice that we have three layers. So layer number 1, layer number 2, and then the layer number 3. So under soil condition observed, ano, using general condition, no, yung nakita. So lahat ang given natin dyan is under general meaning. So using Terzaghi's equation, determine the safe column load P, but you have to consider local shear failure. So you have to convert, no, from general to local. So under gross and soil bearing. Okay, so if you notice, may mga dimension na nadagdag. So we need also to provide the other dimensions like this one. How did we arrive to this 0.3 meters? Note that the height from the NGL, note that this is our natural grade line, okay, as we call it NGL, and then the height is 1.5 meter up to the top of the footing, and then we have 1.2 meter first layered soil, so therefore to get the 0.3 meters, you just deduct, ano, sa 1.5 minus 1.3, so you will get 0.3. So it's easy to get that, no, by using algebraic phrases. While the other one, now this is now the concept. Okay, let's start with this. No, may water table ka. No, meron ka dito, no, symbol ng buoy, B-U-O-Y, no, ibig sabihin yung paglutang. So there is a depth of water as provided, which is 2.8 meters. Okay. Now, ito yung importante. In the analogy of soil, lalo na pag multiple layered, ang titingnan nyo dito ay yung dalawang punto, no? The first point is saang layer kayo ng soil na punta, yung mismong footing, yung ilalim ng foundation. Now notice that this is the region where the depth of footing is found. Okay? So itong layer na to, let's say this is layer number 1, no? Ito na may layer number 2. And then the last layer, tawagin natin layer number 3, nasa baba. You will notice that under layer number 2 is our dimension rectangular footing with 1.8 by 3.75. But the question is, hanggang saan kaya i-analyze? Kasi if you will notice, both equations from Terzaghi's and Bisik, there is only one value for cohesion, one value for the effective unit weight, and one value for the effective pressure, meaning it is being required to have one set of value, or meaning one applicable value. But don't forget that in this statement, we have three sets. Layer 1, layer 2, layer 3 has different properties. So this is what you call multiple layered analogy. So how do we start the check? Ano? So you have to verify the width of the footing to be analyzed. So you say it is the width B. So you have to get the same value, no, of value B, no, projected perpendicularly. So that's why you will notice that there is a value of B also here. Okay? So that is also 1.8. So yun ang gawin nyo muna, no, project that. And then get the layer soil. Tingnan natin kung hanggang sa makakaabot. The question would be, umabot ba ito sa third layer or baka naman sa second layer lang tumama? Kung ito ipapasok yung B, i-assume natin na nasa loob. Meaning, kailangan yung natitirang distansya mo, nandun pa lang din sa loob ng second layer, which is dapat nasa premise ka ng 2.2 meters kung nandun yung yung failure zone, kung tawagin. Ito. This one, no? Yung failure zone, ulitin ko lang, it is located, no? At distance B, measured vertically from the depth of the foundation. No, notice that here, it is being measured here, no? Sa ilalim ng footing. Ayan, no? Dito. Okay. So, you have to measure that perpendicularly. You know what perpendicularly means, no? 90 degrees. So, the same value B. Although, may sinuggest naman si Meyerhoff at saka si Hannah that we can consider the depth of the failure zone. Say, ito siya, yung height na to on depth of failure zone. Yan. So, the depth of the failure zone, no? is just only value B as I've discussed earlier for Lucerne and clay, and twice of the width B, no, for dense sand. Notice that ito kasi tatama, ito ay ma-apply kung saan tumama layer of soil. So meaning you have to understand the condition of the second layer. Tingnan natin kung lumagpas o hindi. Now notice that on the second layer, ang property niya, dahil nandun yung foundation niya, is silty sand. Okay? And the third layer is fine to medium sand. What you're going to analyze is kung nasaan napunta yung foundation depth. Kung saan layer siya nag-exist. So, which is on the second layer as we bind it. No? So, therefore, under silty sand, we can assume that the silty sand is already a loose sand criteria. Kasi we cannot say that the silty sand is an automatic dense. So, it's unsafe to assume based on my understanding and reading on this concept, no, based on the concept of Bowles, Munibudu, Brahadas, and at the same time, Koduto, no, they say the same as well as Kameswara Rao. So they are common that it is safe to assume that the soil is under loose if not directly stated, kasi sinabi lang dito is silty, okay. So, we'll use the condition of B as an automatic or default case. Pero pag sinabing sand, then, well, it's automatic use to B, no? Ito yung magiging, ano natin, final condition kapag talagang really dense yung sand natin. Okay? Now, let me go back here. So, for you to get this 1.4 meter, so, originally, we have 2.2 meters. We have this 0.3 meters there. And then 0.5. So, for me to get this remaining distance, okay, I will mark in violet. Ito. Yan. How do I get that? So, therefore, 2.2 minus 0.3, no? 2.2 minus 0.3 minus 0.5. As simple as that. So that we can now get the distance of 1.4. So, by that, then we can identify that there is a 0.4 meter remaining below. Oh, why did I know that? Number 0.4. The sum of this should be B, as mentioned by Meyerhoff and Hanna. So, it should be B. So, there's a 0.4 meter of a layer of soil on the fine medium sand, no? That will use the parameters. So, meaning, the specific parameters that we are going to use to both Rezagi and Vesic will apply some partitions of parameters, meaning they should have a share or particular weight to analyze kung ilang percent ba ng cohesion na mapupunta as a general value to both conditions, as well as the effective unit weight, and also don't forget pati yung ano, yung ating parameters of the failure angle, no, yung phi. So therefore, from that case, no, dito tayo mag-start ngayon ng case analogy. So by this, we have drawn the failure zone. So, ulitin ko, this is the distance we are going called D sub FZ. Why? Kasi ang some of the books, they are calling just only D. But in our nomenclature, D is the depth of the foundation. No? Ito siya. So, we binded that before as the depth of the foundation. No? Di ako gumamit ng D sub F kasi I have some specific use of what is D sub F later as we proceed with the discussion of design of the column footing. Okay? So, by this now, we can start now. Okay. So, by this figure, we will now start the calculation of each layer. So, we have to identify, note that what is given on each layer, no? Void ratio E, cohesion, and a value of the angle failures. No? So, second layer, we silty sand. Also, don't forget specific gravity of soil solids. So, sa second layer, it was given the moisture content in addition. So, second layer lang yan. And the third layer is para same as with the first. So, it doesn't matter. You have to check, no? Ano ba mga kailangan parameters? So, as much as possible, if you can calculate all important conditions, then you may do so. Tingnan natin kung ano yung mga applicable. In layer number one, we have this, no? Bakit dry unit weight lang ang kinonsider? We don't have a specification of moisture content, no? Hindi binigay ang moisture content, hindi binigay ang degree of saturation, okay? So, therefore, there's no way for us to calculate the moisture unit weight and the degree of saturation. So, that's why it leaves me that the condition is under dry condition. So, what if binigay ang W? Okay? Meaning, the soil is under moist. Okay? What if binigay naman dito is, actually ito, calculable dito yung saturated eh. No? Pero why I cannot assume that the layer of the first, no? Ulitin ko, ito yung layer number 1, ito yung layer number 2, at yung nasa baba, hindi natin alam kung saan ang mararating niya, layer number 3. Don't forget that when a soil is saturated, kaya nasa ilalim siya ng water. So, therefore, as a general rule, kapag ang lupa or layer of soil natin is nasa taas ng water table, but saan ba nakapunta ang water table? So, nandito, no? Mark in blue. Yan. So, the first layer is above the water table means it can be only dry or moist. So, do not say that it is saturated. No? But, of course, kung isang layer lang to, we need to calculate the saturated kasi that's the weakest state of soil. So, very evident yan sa weakest state na gagamitin natin sa general equation ng Terzaghi tsaka ng V6. So, but for the meantime, kapag multiple layer, be specific. So, therefore, kung wala kang parameter for you to calculate the moist unit weight, then just only calculate the dry unit weight. Don't mind the saturated unit weight kasi so far, di pa naman natin siya kailangan. And, of course, so on the second layer, since the second layer, you will notice that there is a layer exposed by water and there's another layer exposed on water. So, unang layer na nasa taas, walang water, and then sa pangalawa, may water. Okay? So, there are two possible layers to consider now. So, by this, so we can calculate, let me designate gamma sub 2 to be the moist unit weight of the second layer. So, know the formula, so you can check that on my past video. No, showing the equations to be understood. And then, there's also saturated kasi may tubig, no? Nakalubog ito, itong region na to. While this one, medyo hindi siya lubog, so it can be dry or moist. But don't forget that we have to use the possible wick. So, we cannot use the dry unit weight on the second layer that is not submerged by water. So, we have to use the moist. Sa rule of weakness yan. So, dry, moist, and sat, okay? So, therefore, dalawa pa ang kalalagyan halos niyan, no? Moist at saka sat. Pero pag there's no way for you to get the moist, then consider the dry. Ibig sabihin, yung ating condition sa soil na nasa taas ng water table is dry. So, ganun lang kasimple. So, therefore, that's why we have calculated these three, no? May gamma sub 2 ka, moist, gamma sat 2 ka, or saturated. Okay. It was stated in the problem that the given are in terms of general. Okay? So, it is under general case, but we have to find out in terms of localized. So, there is a conversion that we should understand. That's why it has the existence of primes. But in our past given, dito sa given na to, walang binigay na local. So, kasi under general pa siya eh. So, we have to convert from general to local by multiplying 2/3, no, on each value. And for the let's say equation times 2/3, and while on the angle, it is the tangent times the 2/3. The very reason is from general to localization or local shear, if you recall, it is the weaker state. Being localized means a weaker state. So we expect that the values by this will be get less. That's why you will arrive ano at 4 KPN 20.2813 as provided, no. Na-discuss na ito sa isang past video ko. Please watch na lang ano regarding sa localization from general to local shear. And might as well consider layer 3. Na it is well understood in layer 3, no, dahil nasa ilalim na siya ng water table. Okay, the entire third layer is totally saturated, meaning I just only have to get the gamma sat under the third layer. So, same as with the ano, cohesion under local and the failure angle under local. So using the two-third rule as mentioned, as suggested by all of the authors of the foundation engineering books. Okay? So by that, no, ito yung mga parameters sa kukunin. But don't forget na kanya-kanyang layer pa lang yan. So wala pa dyan yung iisang value na kukonsider natin. And okay, let's don't forget na syempre, we need to get the effective pressure as part of the Terzaghi and as well as getting the soil bearing capacity, ano, lalo sa pag-compute ng net at saka gross. Okay, so where do we get? Ulitin natin, no, sigma CD prime or yung effective pressure, overburden pressure, is laging kukunin yan up to the bottom of the footing. From what? From the NGL. So you need to understand all layers of soil na tatamaan. Tatamayan dyan. Okay, so first layer, meron tayong 1.2 meter na tuyo. Tapos, under the second layer, no, which is 0.3 plus 0.5 will give us 0.8. Okay? So, under ano siya? Moist unit weight. Moist na siya. So, that's why we arrive on this. So, hindi pa naman sa saturated, ano? Kasi kung ito yung ating consideration, ilalim, wala naman tayong water table sa taas, sa ilalim pa siya, ayan, no? Sa ilalim. So, meaning, there's no effect of pore water pressure. So, you don't have to deduct the pore water pressure on the side of the saturated kasi wala naman tayong saturated condition. So, therefore, what will prevail on layer 1, we need to use the dry unit weight, and on layer 2, we need to use the moist unit weight, not the saturated kasi water table mo ay hindi pa present, no, hanggang sa ilalim ng foundation. Lumagpas nga yung water table pa nga. So that's why we will get 27.3787 as discussed earlier kung paano ginamit. Okay? Okay, itabilang muna natin yung mga values, then let us proceed, no? After knowing those important parameters, so this is the right time for us to consolidate ano yung mga equation values sa kalating pag-isahin, no? Ano yung concept nun? The reason why the existence of failure zone is to make sure that the partitions of the parameters will be treated by means of weights. Bakit weights? Tandaan nyo, sa ilalim na footing na to, may parameter ito soil na to under 1.4. At ito parameter under 0.4 meters. So meaning, pag-iisahin natin type yan. So parang gagawa tayo ng isang equivalent numerical value as suggested by Meyerhoff and Hanna. No? Okay, to get the C prime, don't forget that on second layer, we have C prime calculated. Ito. Which is 4. And on the third layer natin naman, we have 4/3. So therefore, by getting the weight, so for the 4 kilopascal, the height is 1.4 meters. And the total height is 1.8, or let's say B. So plus 4/3 for the third layer, ito yon. And then over with the total height B, kasi yun yung distance B sa ilalim. So you will get 92 over 27 or 3.4074 kilopascal. So ganyan ginagawa. So ito yung C prime na to, ang gagamitin na natin for our Terzaghi's equation. So ganun, no? Ano pa kaya kailangan natin? So meron pang dalawa, no? If you recall, kung merong cohesion, may susunod yan. That is the failure angle. Okay, so ganun din. So, under general, we have the values as specified earlier. So, this one, we have 20.2813. And for the third layer, we have 22.6156. So, the same weights, no? If you will notice, first layer, this one, they are the same. Second layer, this one, no? Nagbabago-bago lang naman. Kasi ito yung weight factors, kung tawagin. No? They are the weight factors. Para at least, ma-assess natin to make them as an equal single layer. Ganyan lang konsepto niya. Kasi equations na pinresent for Tisagin Visig is good for one layer. Ngayon, ang nag-suggest nito is the authors of the Foundation Engineering books and the likes of, as I mentioned earlier, no? So, therefore, it is acceptable to do that as they have mentioned this. Okay? So, then followed by the weakest. So, bakit na-consider si weakest? Kasi di ba may groundwater effect? And then, we have to consider the gamma inside the equation to compute gamma prime. Let's call it now weakest, yung gamma sa loob ng pag-compute ng gamma prime. Eh, kasi hindi natin pwede ma-assume na lahat ay saturated, no? May moist at saka saturated. Now, let us understand how did we use this. For the gamma weakest, the second layer, no? Dalawa na compute. Saturated at saka moist. So, ano ba mas malakas dyan? Ah, mas mahina. Of course, it is the saturated. So, that's why we have to use 17.069 instead of using 13.07041. No? Huwag ito. Because this is not the weakest. So, the saturated, why? Why yan ang pinaka-weakest? Kasi may water ka dito na tumama sa second layer. So, nahati siya sa dalawang condition. Pero, pagdating sa third layer, bakit saturated lang? Kasi there's no way for the third layer to become moist or dry. So, therefore, automatic yung gagamitin natin. No? With the same weight factors for each affected layers. Okay? So, by that, we can now have 17.1612. So, ito equivalent na parang, sabihin na natin na, pwede yung isipin na saturated, but I cannot call it saturated kasi naghalo eh. Pwede kasing walang tubig dyan eh. Right? So, pwede mag-gamma moist ka sa taas, lalo na kung walang water table. Pwede kong tanggalin yan. Yung water table, pwede mawala yan. Baka pwede nasa ilalim yan ng ano. Low, if you recall the zone of intermittent region. So, pwede siyang, yung lower limit, no, nasa pinakababa. So, pwede mangyari na yung gamma prime mo is equal sa gamma weakest. So, meaning, wala kang saturation presence. So, pwede may moist na mag-combine. But here, nagkataon lang na second and third mo ay parehas na may saturation kasi parehas may parting lubog sa water table. Ngayon, pagka pumantay dito yung water table mo sa in between second and third, so most likely, yung second layer mo, walang saturation yan. So, gamma lang ito. Tsaka gamma dry, kung pwede makompute yung gamma dry. But, the weakest is still gamma. Pero sa ilalim, kung na, ito yung water table mo, oh, this is just only gamma sat. Ayan. Sana malinaw, ano? Saturday will be just only gamma sat. Kung ano yung water table, and so on. I think, nakuha nyo na kung ano yung, ano, konsepto on how to select the weakest. Okay, so this time let us use the computed values. But of course, one of the important parameters is to get the condition of Terzaghi by allowing the calculation of the soil bearing factor. So tatlo yan, no? For N sub Q, or tawagin nating ano, soil bearing factor for effective pressure. But don't forget, bakit may prime? Automatic kasi, no? This is local, eh. No, we convert from general to local. Usually, pag nagkaka-prime, that is under local. Okay? So, therefore, using the equation, you will get this one, no? Nasa discussion man natin ito before. And NC prime, which is under cohesion soil bearing factor effective, we will have 18.669. And the N gamma. Total, wala siyang KP gamma na given or the shear factor for identifying the effective unit weight, which is the very weakest of the soil. So, we will use the empirical condition as suggested. So, we will get 4.9047. Pero, pag binigay yung KP gamma, you have to proceed with the calculation using the KP gamma. Nandun yan sa discussion ko on the past video, no? Please check it, no? Para makita niya kung paano siya, ano yung equation na pwedeng gamitin. But again, we'll use this one, N gamma. There's a prime here, no? Don't forget. There's a prime, no? So, to find out the N gamma prime or N gamma kapag may given N na KP gamma. Okay? So, ulitin ko lang, ano, ito, no, may prime yan. Okay. Now, using Terzaghi, let's find out, no, yung condition na groundwater effect. So, the depth of water is 2.8. I'll mark in red para mas visible. So, the depth of water is 2.8 measured. Lahat yan, no, measured tayo sa NGL. And the total depth of the footing embedment or depth of footing is 2. If you add 1.5 and 0.5. And don't forget the special parameter D plus B. So, D as 2 plus 1.8 as the B, we get 3.8. And then you compare. So, nagkataon na pare sila nag less than. So, meaning, ito yung magpa-provide ng gamma prime. Again, I have binded here as gamma weakest para di na kayo malito. So, the gamma weakest, nakumpita natin kanina by combining the two layers of soil. Na, ngayon, no, paano pag tatlong layer? So, let's say, paano pag tatlo? Sige, just in case, na mangyari. No, nagkaroon ka dito na footing. Tapos, sa sobrang haba niya, umabot pa dito. So, you will get the factors. They say, I say this as, I would not get this. They say this is distance of A. Yan, compute nyo lang yan. Distance of B, meaning the distance of B is a total height of layer. And then distance of C, calculable mas sa natitira. Now, note that this is a distance of B or padding 2B. No? Padding 2B din yan, depende sa type of soil. Kapag 2B, gagamitin yan pag dense. Ulitin ko, gagamitin lang yung 2B kapag dense sand. Yung meron tayo. Otherwise, use B. Okay. So, ano factor nito? Nung nasa ilalim na to? Para malinaw. So, that is, kung ano mong value netong layer na to, you have to multiply by A over B. Yan yung factor. Para dito, kung ano mong factor na or specifications na meron dito, okay, you have to multiply it by B over big B. While ito, C over B. Yan yung mga weight factors. Saka, pag tatlo or more than pa nga, pwede pa. I think it's now clear, no, on how to assess that. Okay? So, para hindi na kayo malito next time whenever you encounter more than one layer soil. Now, to continue, yung ultimate, no, ito yung formula natin sa rectangular. Please view it na lang ano, sa ating past video in my discussion of physics and Terzaghi's equation. So, therefore, you will get 341.4181. I just supplied all parameters. So, ito yung gamit niyan. Kasi isa lang yung gamma prime na equation mo. Okay, isa lang naman yung C prime na equation tsaka na gamma weakest kasi in terms of the gamma prime. Kasi sa gamma weakest, inilagay mo na dito. Ayan. Just supply. Then, don't forget that the unit weight of water is 9.81. Okay? So, by that, you can now calculate as 341.4181, no? Observing all the parameters. Ito yung, ano, no? 1 plus 0.3, B over L, C prime, ito yun, and then N C prime, and then this is the sigma ZD prime times N Q prime, then 0.5 as measured as minus 0.2 B over L, gamma prime, B, N, gamma prime. Okay? As clear as that. Ngayon, let me put the value beside the Terzaghi's equation. No? So, therefore, considering gross soil bearing, if you recall, lahat ng weights na may kukonsider. But don't forget, ngayon, ang weight of the footing natin is 1.8 by 3.75 by thickness of 0.5 meter. So, again, we will get 79.461. Now, notice that hindi binigay yung dimension ng column. So, it won't take effect. So, na-discuss ko naman before in the past video, right before this, but what if merong column? So, diniscuss ko rin doon, please understand that you have to get the story height, the half of the story height, exposed story height, plus the remaining ano column length below the soil. No. So, weight of the soil, dalawa. Itong soil na to, at saka, yung soil na hanggang dito. Kasi yun yung consider natin yung bigat eh. Yung matatamaang bigat. So, therefore, kaya meron ako ditong 1.2 meter para dito. Okay? At saka 0.3 para dito sa top of the footing. Tatama dyan. So, what particular element? Ngayon, wala namang water doon sa elevations niya. So, ito, magte-take effect as gamma dry. Kasi gamma day lang matang property ng first layer mo. Tapos, si second layer, gamma moist. Wala naman saturations na nakita doon sa within the 0.3 meter range times the area for bearing ng footing. This is 1.8 by 3.75. So you will get 138.5548. So therefore, you will now compute the Q sub A or the allowable soil bearing under gross, which is ano lang yan, no? Q ultimate over factor of safety. Then you will get 97.548 kPa. And then, don't forget on how to calculate the condition where you have to add all the forces, including the force P, footing weight, and then the soil weight. At wala tayong surcharge. Bakit wala akong kinusider ng pore water pressure? Bakit zero yan? The water table does not take an influence din sa ating depth of footing. Ang titingnan nyo kasi dito, yung papataas. May tubig ba dyan? Wala. So, pore water pressure, zero. Pero pag, katulad ng last problem natin, na kinonsider ko yung may pore water pressure, okay, dito napunta. Laging nasa taas ngayon ng elevation. So, therefore, you need to deduct this pore water pressure from the NGL, no, if you recall. So, ibabawas natin yan. At saka ito, may region dito, no, of course, kung weight lang na footing kailangan mo, well, wala saturation dito. Pero pag water table mo, pumunta dito, may degree of saturation ganyan. So, gamma sat, no, hindi na siya gamma moist sa pagkuha ng weight of the soil. Ganun lang. So, therefore, P is considered as 440.432. Meaning, if you have a value that is more than 440, so your column is already unsafe. No? Actually, we can state in this way, you know, pwede rin, that the soil is already unsafe for the foundation to be placed with. Kasi lalaki na yung ano, yung effectivity pressures saka yung titawag nating settlement. Malaki factor na yun. By this, no, we can calculate no, net soil bearing. So Q ultimate lang yun, no, minus the ano, sigma ZD prime. So you will get this 89.7255 and finally you will get based on P over A lang yan. So 1.8 by 3.75 yung bearing capacity area. So, meaning we can now get 605.647. So, I think I have discussed on the past video on how to get the net soil bearing. So, by this, now we have calculated the two values, value of P. So, zero on safe ngayon. So, if you recall, kung kanina is mababa sa 605, so magpe-prevail yun nasa gross. Kasi yung P natin kaya ta natin kanina mas mababa no, sa nakuha natin. So, by that, now we can conclude that if we are being asked sino kaya yung pinaka safe no na soil condition, which is kanina we have calculated 440.432 kilonewton. So the safe load P, kung isa lang ang tinatanong, is 440.432 kasi condition is less than or equal. Ayan, no? 605 is more than 440, no? So we cannot accept 605. So therefore, the safest, kung sakaling tanungin, is 440.432 kilonewton. Okay, thanks for viewing. Don't forget to subscribe to my YT channel. Hit the like and share button below. And as a tradition, you have been neurorized. Thanks for viewing and then see you in our next educational video tutorial.